Hello everyone, we are batch 24 of computer science department of MIT Mysore. In this video, we walk through the major project that is real-time monitoring of water quality in IoT environment. This project is done under the guidance of Assistant Professor P.C. Now let us introduce ourselves. My name is Purana Pragna.
My name is Kiran M.
Miss Aishwarya S.
My name is Rahul R.A.
So, in this, I will discuss the introduction part of the project and the influence of literature survey. So basically, in order to ensure safe supply of drinking water, the quality needs to be monitored in real time. So, we are doing the project in an IoT environment that we need to monitor the water quality. So, how we do that is that using IoT environment. So, in order to ensure safe supply of the drinking water, quality of the water needs to be monitored in real time, the first thing. Second thing is the low-cost system of for real-time monitoring of water quality in an environment. So, basically, our project is of that low-cost. The main main thing is that to maintain the low-cost system, second point. The third point is, in this project, we have used few sensors. Which are those sensors? pH sensor, temperature sensor, turbidity sensor, and flow sensor. Why do we use the sensors? Because to measure the physical and chemical parameters of water. So what is the physical and the chemical parameters? Basically, the pH. The pH of the water is a chemical parameter of a water. So using pH sensor, we are measuring the chemical parameter of the water. What is the physical parameter? A temperature is a physical parameter and the turbidity is a physical parameter. So by using temperature sensor and turbidity sensor, we are measuring the temperature and the turbidity respectively of the water. So after measuring the values through the sensor, what do we do? After measuring the values from the sensor values will be processed by the core controller. That is, we are using Arduino Uno microcontroller. So these values will be controlled, processed by the core controller. This is one thing. So the main objective when it comes to any project, be it any project, we need to specify the objectives. We need to make sure that it has some objectives in our project. So what are the objectives of our project? The main objective, as I earlierly told, the main objective of our project is to ensure good quality of drinking water. So the second one is that the most economical and convenient way to monitoring the water quality. How do we describe the economical way using the low cost sensors, using low cost boards and the components which is of low cost? Now by this, we are ensuring that the project is of economically low project. Third one is, we are supposed to bring the environment into the real life. How we do is that, see, basically we have a plant, we have a water. So here in our project, we are taking water. Water is a part of environment. It is an essential part of environment. So what are we doing here? We are bringing water into real life. How we are doing is that we are making water and the network in both interact. So we are bringing the water into the environment into the real life. So this is one of the objectives. The third one is to keep the embedded device in environment for monitoring, which enables self-protection to the environment. So what are the embedded devices? What are the components that we are using in the embedded devices in the environment? So for example, we are using sensors. We are using microcontroller. We are using driving motors in this project. So we use all these components to ensure the protection to the water. So that obviously means to ensure the protection to the environment. These are the objectives of our project. So the next one is, so if we want to do one project, if we want to do one major project, we need to get influenced by various other papers, research papers, literature surveys, and other projects. So we cannot do this project by default or by scratch. We need to do some research. We need to analyze the previous projects. We need to make a analysis of previous things, and we need to determine what we should do in our project. We need to we need to also ensure that we are doing better. We are doing better than the previous ones. So how we do is that we cross all the limitations of previous projects. So in our project, we have, in this presentation, we have actually mentioned 4 literature survey papers. One is of that an IoT based self-regulating sensors for water quality monitoring. This is the name of the title of the project. It was published in 2018. So the what was the proposed work in that paper? To prevent harmful pollutants enter in the water resources and ensure safe drinking water. The same objective of us. This is one of the objectives. So the objectives is not like any different. So this is one thing. And what are the methods that were used in the project, in that project? That different water quality checking sensors, GSM, Arduino, you know. So the method also, the components were also almost same. But the limitation is what plays a major role, because we need to ensure that we are not doing that mistake. We are upgrading our project from the previous projects. So what are the limitations? No alert messages even when the water level goes abnormal. But in our project, we will get an alert message from an application. So this is one of the difference between our project and this project. Next one is Internet of Things based on smart water quality monitoring system. This was published in 2018 again. So the proposed work and objective is to reduce the complexity and increase the performance by collecting the data of water parameters. So almost same. But here the components is different. What are the components that slightly different? What is that? Core controller ARM. So basically ARM core controller is very costly and is very it takes so much space. That is one thing. And it is very costly and it is heavy. That is one thing. pH sensor, same. CO2 sensor, we are not using in this. Water level sensor, yes, we are using. Wi-Fi module, we are using. So here, what is the limitation of this project? The complexity is more and the cost is high. Why cost is high? The ARM controller costs more than the microcontroller that we are using. That is Arduino microcontroller. Second one is IoT based low cost system for monitoring of water quality in real time. That was published in 2018 again. The quality checking of water in real time favorable for living beings and plants. Same objective of us. The methods used were Raspberry Pi models and ThingSpeaking API and different sensor. Here in our project, we are not using Raspberry Pi. So the limitation of this project is that determining TDS in water is time consuming, not a remote monitoring system. Okay. So the main difference is here. In our project, we can remote monitor our system. Okay. We can sit at our home. We can control the water quality monitoring system, which is in Bangalore, using our application. So, but in this project, they cannot determine or they cannot control the system using remote monitoring. That is one thing. Determining TDS value TDS in water is time consuming. In our project, it is not time consuming. We will get the result in seconds. the last one is the water quality monitoring system based on IoT platform. It was published in 2019. Low cost for monitoring water quality in IoT environment. Same objective of us. Different sensors, pH sensor, temperature sensor, temperature sensor, and Raspberry Pi. Here we are not using Raspberry Pi. We are using Arduino microcontroller. To set sensor values, it's time consuming and requires certain time period to take stabilize. To set sensor values, it is not time consuming in our project, whereas it is a limitation of this project. This is about the literature survey that we have done. So what is the main objective of doing literature survey is that analyzing previous papers, finding out their limitations, not repeating the same same mistake or the not getting the same limitation into our project, but we have to upgrade our project from the previous. This is the reason why we do literature survey. So this is about the introduction and literature survey that is done by me. The next one, existing system and proposed system, will be discussed by Aishwarya S.
Okay. When it comes to existing system, in many countries, the water quality, in many countries, most of the rivers have the water quality monitor systems, and they do not give a real-time water quality due to the lack of new technologies like IoT. Along with it, they are mostly based on ARM11 processor, which requires a large-scale hardware, which are costly to buy as well as to maintain. So, moreover, they require constant monitoring, and these results are need to be calculated manually. So, in order to overcome these conditions, we need to develop a new system. So, we have proposed a low-cost system to overcome all these conditions. Next comes to proposed approach. Proposed system.
Go on, next slide.
Okay. In our proposed system, we are using the core controller, the temperature sensor, turbidity sensor, pH sensor, and the flow sensors. These can be read directly from the command line. Okay. This command line requires us to input a command every time we want to know the sensor reading. So in order to access all the terminals of the sensor, we are using a C++ program, so which will read the sensor value and automatically gives the result at the set intervals. In our proposed system, the microcontroller comes equipped with the large drivers for interfacing. These microcontrollers collect the sensor data and analyze the collected data. So after the predefined analysis, it sends the signals to the Wi-Fi to transfer the collected data to the cloud server using the MQTT protocols. So on the receiver side of the cloud, we are using the Android application, which is used to monitor the data. In this Android application, we can monitor every parameter and it can be stored in the database for the future references. So when the data of the sensor is abnormal, it gives us a pop-up notification. So next thing, the limitations of the existing system and the result will be discussed by Kiran.
Okay. As of now, we've gone through about the existing system and our proposed work, where here the proposed work should be have some modification, or it should be have some changes or something better than the existing system. Why? Because we have to overcome some limitations for achieving that. Which are those? I will explain now. We found those limitations in existing systems. Those are, the firstly, basically we are looking into a cost-effective system to make this to reach widely. To reach this to widely, we are first ensuring the cost effective system. And in existing system, the processor cost and the sensor cost are high. So we are choosing a low cost sensors or maybe a microcontroller like Arduino Uno, those stuffs. And next thing is, in some existing system, there is some difficulty in understanding water parameters and comes to the conclusion later after getting the output is a little bit difficult. After seeing the result, we can't come to the conclusion easily. So this is also one of the drawback we can find in the existing system. And the next thing is, in some existing system, each value should monitor constantly. The values, each and every value should be monitored constantly. Then only we can lead to the final output. Without monitoring constantly, we can't get the proper or exact output. So that won't be the limitation. And the next thing is, a human calculation or human intervention is needed a lot in what the existing system having more calculation kind of things like that, and which is a time consuming one. This also one of the limitation. And the next is, some are not in real time. What are the existing system are there now, some are not in real time. We will inputting the water and we will get the result in a next day or in a 2 days like that. This is not in a real time, and some are not in a remote monitoring kind of system. And in some case, we can found there is a huge deployment of hardware like things. These are the limitations of the existing system. And we will move to the next slide, Puruna. Next slide. In our project, the result will be like this. This is the result part of our project, where we can observe easily. We can see the pH value directly, and we can see the temperature, turbidity, and the water inflow. Here, it's indicating what amount of pH the sample water is giving, like 6.8. It's showing there. And the turbidity values, NTU, nephelometric turbidity units, in that unit, it's showing the values, and the temperature value, and the water inflow, how much of water you take for getting the output, like that. And everything is showing here. Any person can see this. They can easily grab the things. With a less amount of knowledge, he can get the things. So it will show the next, after intaking some water, after giving some pH, some turbidity, temperature, like that, it will show like the water quality is, what is the water quality here for these types of parameter, what is the water quality? The water quality is good. It's showing like, because it's satisfying the parameters, what is required for good drinking water. It's satisfying the parameter, like it should be less than 4 NTU for a turbidity and the pH, the temperature, everything. That's why it's showing the water quality is good. The next thing is, this is for a good water quality, water sample, we can say. The next thing, what if the bad water means not for a good drinking purpose? And next slide, Puna. We can explain in the next slide, that one. Here, we can observe, it's also showing every values like pH, turbidity, temperature, and water inflow, where we can observe here the same intake 2 liters, where the turbidity value are reaching, exceeding the limit, the good quality limit. It's exceeding the good quality limit, like it's exceeding 4.25. It's exceeding 4. So it's not good for drinking purpose. That's why here it's showing the water quality is not good. The water quality is not good. It's showing directly. Anybody can see this result in a page. He can easily understand the things. This is the result part of our project. Not only this, we will move a step and we explain this in a graphically beautiful manner. That's will explained by Rahul. That's one also our result part. Next slide will be explained by Rahul.
So as Kiran discussed about the result, what will be the output of our project, we can show the output in the graphical representation also, as we have got the output as water is not good because it is acidic, because the pH is less than 7. So we have got the output as water is not good and acidic. This can be shown in the graphical representation as shown in this snapshot. What actually this graphical representation shows means graphical representation will be showing in the real time data. In below, it has given that there is different options. We can see the graphical representation. If you want for 1 day, we can see the graphical representation for 1 day. We have shown the graphical representation for 1 day for water is not good. For water is not good. If you want the graphical representation for every 15 minutes, we can also switch into every 15 minutes. Or else, when we monitoring the system, if you want to see the graphical representation in the real time, we can put into live option. If you put into the live option, the graphical representation will be showing in the, it will be moving on in the real time data. Next slide. Next, we have also shown the graphical representation for the water quality is good. And this water is normal because the pH level is 7 and the temperature is 24.25 degrees Celsius and the water flow intake is 0.7. The pH is good. That's why the water quality is good and it is normal. We can also see the graphical representation for this also. Here we have shown this graphical representation for every 15 minutes. So that's why the graphical representation is different when compared to 1 day. Like this, we can show the graphical representation of our project, of the output of our project. Now let us go to the conclusion of our project. Mainly, in our project, we use the cloud computing technology. When we use this cloud computing technology, this is used to monitor the data on the internet easily, and the time is reduced and the cost is low in the environmental management also. And in our project, the levels of pollution in the water bodies are taken, and the sudden warnings are sent to the public through messages or pop-up notifications or with Gmail. We can set an alarm and send to the public through messages. And this task of monitoring system can be done using less trained individuals. It does not need any complicated. It will be easy to monitor the system by any human being. Any human does not need any trained individuals. And the installation of the system can be also done very easily when it is near the target. And the real-time water quality monitoring system for real-time applications, which is efficient and a low-cost system, has been tested after implementation also. Thank you. Next. Purna, next.
Hello everyone. Our project is real-time monitoring of water quality in IoT environment. We are batch 24. We are doing under the guidance of Deepthi ma'am, and the co-evaluators are Suhas sir and Lokesh sir. This is the entire setup of our project, and the next the working procedure of the project will be explained with my teammates.
For the project that we are doing, first we have to prepare buffer solutions. For that we have taken 2 cups, one to prepare for pH 4 solution, another one is for pH 7. I'll write it first. So as we know, pH 4 happens to be a acidic solution, pH 7 happens to be a neutral solution. So we have written both the pHs, one is pH 4 and pH 7 in the cups. So we will first prepare the pH 4 solution by adding tablets, buffer tablets. So this happens to be a buffer tablet. Usually we add this one whole tablet to 100 ml water. Since we are not taking 100 ml in this thing, we are adding some minimum quantity of powder into this. So for this we need to add water, not drinking water, of course. We have taken distilled water. So why we have taken distilled water is that here the oxygen will be dissolved. The pH of the distilled water will be around 7.5 to 9. So we are adding this distilled water to the tablet that we have taken. So this will convert into the acid solution, acid. So for this, I think we need to add some more tablet. So yes, here we have prepared a acidic solution. If you want, we can add some more distilled water to this. So here we have we are done with the pH 4 solution. So this is one thing. We'll keep this aside, and now we have to prepare pH 7 that we have written in the cup. We have to prepare pH 7 for that. There is another tablet for this pH 7 tablet. This is pH 7 tablet. So we are mixing the pH 7 tablet to the distilled water. First, I add this to this cup. Next, I will add the distilled water that we have taken. We already did this for pH 4 solution also. So here there will be, we witness no color change. In the acidic tablet, we witness yellow color. Here there will be no color change, that the water remain neutral. So this is pH 7. So we have taken two solutions. Why we are taking these two solutions? We need to check whether the pH sensor is working properly or not. So here we are done with two solutions, one is pH 4 and pH 7. Due to the acidic content, the pH 4 solution has turned into yellow color. Here the pH 7 has remained neutral, so there is no color change in this thing. Hello, this is our project, the real-time water quality monitoring using IoT. So basically, I'm explaining about the components of the project. Here we are taking four tubs. Okay, the first one tub happens to be to take the water, to intake the water to the next tub. So how we intake this? We are using motors. The motor will pump the water into the valve. So this is primary tub. This is the first tub that we are using. Through this, the water flows through this valve. Here we have attached the flow sensor to determine the quantity of the water, that how much water should we take. So that is determined by the flow sensor. Next, the water flows into this tub. This is the second tub. In this tub, we are applying three sensors. One is pH sensor. This is an electrode of pH sensor. This is the pH sensor, the pH board that controls the electrode. So here it will be deployed like this. The next one is turbidity sensor. So what is turbidity? Turbidity is a cloudiness of water. So determine the cloudiness of water, this turbidity sensor is used. Next one is temperature sensor. So where is the temperature sensor? Is to determine the temperature of the water that we take. So this is temperature sensor. This is temperature sensor. So the water is taken into this tub from the use of motor. The water is pumped into the valve. Then the quantity of the water is determined by the flow sensor. Then the water is pumped, flown into the second tub, where the quantity of the water is sensed from the sensor. One is pH sensor, turbidity sensor, and the temperature sensor. If everything is proper, if the water quality is good, then the water flows into this tub by the help of pump. Next, if the water quality is not good, for example, if the pH is not proper, if the turbidity is not proper, then the water will drain into this tub using another pump. So this is the components. The next board thing components will be explained by Aishwarya.
Hello. Now I am going to explain the components on this board. This is the pH sensor board, and this is the pH electrode which is connected to the sensor board. This is used to calculate the pH value of the water. And this is the turbidity sensor board, which is this is the turbidity sensor which is connected to this to control the turbidity value. This is the main controller we are using. Here we are using Arduino microcontroller. These two are the motor drivers, which is used to control the motor pumps which we are inserted here. This is the Wi-Fi module. We are using non-MCU Wi-Fi module. This Wi-Fi module is used to send the data to the cloud. This is the LCD display, which displays the values locally before sending it to the Android app. So the delay will be 1 second for displaying in this LCD and also in the Android app.
Hello, now we are explaining the working procedure for our project. We are putting some amount of water into this bucket. After putting the water into this bucket, we want to put the pH electrode into this main bucket.
So hello again. As we have explained the components and the major things that we have taken to the project, here we have taken some amount of water into the first step. So now I am giving the power connection to the project. So yes, so you can observe here the water from this tub is getting pumped by the motor and passing through the valve, and the flow sensor is detecting the quantity of the water. It is falling into the next tub, where the major three sensors have been deployed. One is pH sensor, another one is WD sensor, another one is temperature sensor. So here, coming to here, the values have been locally displayed here. So you can observe the turbidity value is 3.346, it is varying, the temperature is also varying, the pH value is still not showing. So we have to wait till the water is 2 liters of the water is here, then only the values is determined by the sensor, and then it will be passed into the next tub if the water quality is good. If the water's quality is not good, it will be drained into this tub. So this is about the project. Now we shall wait till the water is filled, 2 liters of the water is filled in this tub. So yeah, so you can see here the water the water quantity reached 2 liters, and then the water quality is good, the pH is good, and the turbidity value is good. Then only the water is passed into the next tub, that water is, the water quality is good. So here, see, so we have to send these values to the server. How are we doing this? The microcontroller, the processed values will be sent to the server through this NodeMCU Wi-Fi module. Then the values will be sent to the application that I am showing here. So these are the values, but the delay will be there between two local between the board and the Android application. That will be around 1 microsecond. So here you can see that pH value, turbidity value, temperature value, water flow. The water is good, normal. So the quality is normal. So here we can also see the graphical representation of the sensor data. So here this is about the pH sensor. Here we can see the turbidity value. Here this is water intake value. Here this is temperature. So this is how the entire project works. The sensor data can also be represented in CSV format, that is comma separated value format. That here the water quality report, if we press this icon, the report will be sent to the mail ID. So yes, I'll do that. Generating report. The latest report is in your inbox. So we shall wait until the report comes. Oh yes, I got the report here. I am ready with my email. So this is the report that I can show you. Yes. So here I have downloaded the report that was received into my inbox, mail inbox. So here I have pH value, temperature value, turbidity value in water flow in the CSV. These data are in the CSV format. So I shall open the pH sensor value. So here you can see that there are different timestamps and the respective pH values. So this has been like this. Next one is the temperature. Similarly, the temperature timestamps and the respective temperature values have been recorded. Similarly, the turbidity value and likewise water inflow value. So this is So this is how the values are recorded into the report. So earlierly we had taken a treated water to check whether the water is good or not. Now earlierly the water had to flow to the final tub. Now we cannot change the pH value of this treated water. So hence what we are doing is that we are taking a buffer solution. Buffer solution's pH is 4. So you can see the color, since it is an acidic solution, the color has turned to yellow. Now what we are doing is we are putting this pH sensor into this cup so that the pH value, so pH value will, value will be the pH value of this is 4. The pH value that we, so now we are simulating this value where the pH value is less than the normal. So let us power on the. Here what happens is after filling the complete tub, we have put the pH sensor into this buffer solution. So the water, the value is less than the normal. So water should get drained. It should not go into the final tub. So it should get drained. So we will filter that in this way. Here you can see that the water is getting drained into this tub. Why? Why is that? Why is this happening? Because the pH electrode is dipped into this pH 4 solution. So the water quality is not good. Hence the water is getting drained and it is not flowing into the final tub. This is how it works.